I would now like to invite Mr. Mahesh Kulkarni on the dais and enlighten us with his words of wisdom. Mr. Mahesh Kulkarni is Associate Director at Center for Development of Advanced Computing and heads GIST Research Labs, the Language Technology Group. After doing his master's degree in science, special electronics, he has worked in both public and private sectors. He started his career as a development engineer, working in the area of ELCB, MCB, and was assistant manager in Nelco Tata Group of Company in Nasik and Mumbai for over a period of 9 years. He has extensively worked upon super mini systems and telecommunication systems and was instrumental in bringing the technology to India. Mr. Kulkarni has several publications to his credit in the areas of research and development, published in various journals and international conferences, IT ERA 2003, Cyber World 2003, Singapore, Chartered Secretary General, COSCODA/International Localization Summit. An articulate speaker, he is much sought after at meetings both in India and abroad and has represented CDAC as well as the DIT at various forums and meetings pertaining to standardization, language issues, internationalized domain names, translation, localization, to name a few. Apart from initiating various research projects within CDAC, he has been instrumental in getting and executing projects from various multinational companies. As a part of the European-funded projects, he has spearheaded international conference, EU workshops, research organized at Paramaribo, New York, and Johannesburg. During his long association with CDAC, Mr. Mahesh Kulkarni has, to his credit, patents as well as copyrights pertaining to language and language technology. Sir, you're cordially welcome on stage.
And I first and foremost, CDAC, you may be aware what CDAC is doing. CDAC is an organization which is a research and development organization under the Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, Government of India. And we generally work on a lot of thematic areas, especially. And you may be aware that CDAC was started with the sole game of looking at the supercomputers. So the denial of supercomputers by US to us has led to the birth of CDAC. At the similar time, basically, we started working on something called the language technology. One second, let me get the thing started. Okay, so we started working on language technology, and today CDAC is like omnipresence. It's almost 13 locations all over the country. Close to around 3,500 very strong R&D workforce, and working in various thematic area which has got a national as well as an international impact. I look after the language technology division of CDAC and have been working since almost like 20-25 years on this area. It is really good to see a lot of startup people coming over here, or the to be startups basically. And I think you are fully aware, I need not tell you that what is called the importance of so-called the IP, okay, in any business for that matter. And especially towards the startup itself, because you have got some idea, there is a fear that that idea can be easily snatched or it can be easily copied. And then you do have a problem. So I think it's a very important, today's invite is very important in regards with what are the challenges or what are the issues in relation with a startup, as well as why it is very important to have the patent protections to be done. MIT is our parent body, so we as a MIT basically, as a CDAC, helps basically as a technology partner to MIT. Dr. Ajay Garg is heading the IPR division as well, innovation and IPR division at MIT. And at CDAC, we are helping them out in terms of promoting, proliferating startups in regards with all the activities related to the patents. So there are a couple of initiatives which have been undertaken under this particular program, and this is today's program is one such program wherein the government actually sponsors us and basically makes an attempt to reach out to the people. So these are the MIT APR initiatives. So objectives are creating awareness, facilitating support, promoting IPR in the field of ICT. So this is a major work what we are trying to do, because since we know the technology, we know the R part of it, we know how much it is very, very important to have a protection of your intellectual properties. So intellectual properties is not all about patents, but it is all about copyrights, designs, geographical indications, and so on and so forth. So you may be aware of those type of stuff. Especially people into the rural environment may be very much interested in looking at geographical indications and so on. So under the MIT IPR initiatives, creating infrastructure for creation of an IPR ecosystem by way of development and support of tools and technologies. So it's not all about only awareness or promotion, but we do have a portal also, which is named as ict-ipr.in, and you can, one can go, especially for the SME sector or the startups, basically one can go and avail the services. Currently those services which are there, they are freely, fully available freely to improvise or increase the patent filing within India. Before I go, I think I forgot one more thing to mention, is that I think there was a QR code displayed onto the registration desk. So we are going to have a quiz basically with all you people. I hope you participate in that. And you can download, that is a small app basically. You just click on the QR code and you can download the app on your mobile. There are just simple 15 questions related to IP. They are not very difficult, and I think you can try all of them. And those questions we'll try to look at who has actually scored better. And at the end of the day, probably some motivational measures will be definitely be taken up. So we'll have some awards for three people at least, basically. So I request you to just download, and whenever we are working on this or the speakers are going to speak, you can take the basically quiz. And if any issues are there related with downloading or something, you can get in touch with Parimal Khare, who is sitting here. He's my colleague from Pune. So coming to the initiatives of the MIT, especially carrying through the CDAC, is the IPR awareness scheme basically. So this is one of the programs which we are conducting today. SIPEIT scheme is also there. Then we have got a Center for Excellence in IP established at CDAC Pune as well as MIT Delhi, and we wanted to grow it further. And then you may be aware of, there is something called the IPOS Panorama. Basically, it's a multimedia learning tool basically for IP and IP related stuff. It's a very intuitive one. So we have localized the IP panorama in regards with the Indian requirements, and that is also made freely available. One can ask for the series, or one can actually view it on the web or on the mobile also. So that is also very recent work what has happened. Then we also do the IPR facilitation and the support, and I have got some international cooperation. So we work with EPOs and WIPO, especially in regards with some of these awareness campaigns. We have conducted various conferences nationally, internationally in this particular area. And maybe Dr. Ajay Garg will be dwelling it further on those type of stuff, what we are doing as an international cooperation. So in the IPR awareness scheme, the scheme is for the period of 5 years. I'm not going to get exactly into the details, but you should be aware about the scheme, and it is up to 19. Proposals for support under the program will be issued online. Academic institutions dealing in ICT and E course, industry bodies are eligible to apply. Support for awareness program, around 2 lakhs is being given from the government side in regards with conducting such type of programs, as well as the 3 lakh rupees for the awareness program to be organized by the industry. So we have got a couple of programs for awareness raising, because if you see globally, India is lagging in terms of IPR filing. There are variety of reasons towards that, but definitely we need to increase increase our IPR portfolio. That is very, very crucial. Most of the companies, the industries which I generally see, they shy away from filing the IP basically. They shy away. Today people are a little bit aware that IP becomes very important. Secondly, it is not all about protecting your IP, but it is all about intentionally or unintentionally infringing in whatever work we are doing or whatever activity we are doing has been intentionally or unintentionally is infringed. So there are cases, lot of cases you must have seen nationally as well as internationally, and people have been sued for huge amounts. So both ways. So one is to make oneself aware of IP as well as one need to know what to do and what not to do. So currently the outcome of the workshops is totally, we have conducted 50 plus workshops and the details are available. You can go through that, the details of the scheme is available. And Dr. Garg will touch upon more on this particular portion separately. So these are the snapshots of the courses. Basically, under the MIT. And the objective of the scheme is essential for micro, small, medium enterprises and technology startup units. So you will fit into that. And I think government has already taken care in regards with making very easy processes in regards with of startup filing and patent. So we will be definitely assisting you people if somebody requires our help in regards with assistance. So we will be definitely coming to your rescue. Financial support for international patent filing to encourage innovation and recognize the value and capabilities of global IP. So this is also a part of the scheme. The scheme gives something close to around maximum 15 lakh of rupees for international filing, either by an individual or even by the SME or startup. Okay. The scheme is available online. Applicant can apply online. Applicant can be enterprise or individual. Up to 5 applications can be accepted for financial year from a single applicant. Conditions of eligibility relaxed to attract maximum participation from MSME and startups. Speedier and single window clearance, which Dr. Garg is handling all this stuff. So I will not get into the details of the eligibility, but as you can see, it is for startups and SMEs and individuals also can actually get benefited from this, especially in regards with the international patent filing. So these are some of the, not that encouraging, but yes, there were a lot of MIT has approved 30 cases, startup supported 12, MSMEs supported 16, technology incubation enterprise 2 are supported. How to apply? You can just go to the ICT-IPR or the SIP EIT and then you will be able to get all the details towards that. Then one more initiative what we did is that to start with something called the Center for Excellence in IP, and that is, as I said to you, it is a center which is being established at MIT level, and one cell is at Pune and another is at Delhi. So we do a lot of work over there. So we do prior art searches basically. The main services, as I said, they are prior art searches, invention analysis, handling the IPR queries, then we also do the patent alerts. So we have got an app, a mobile app. You can actually download that mobile app and you can see to it the area of interest which you would like to see the patents and so on and so forth. So it is like the news alerts you receive from that. So it's a very simple intuitive application you can download. That will be coming up very handy. Also, one can go through the IP panorama from that and so on and so forth. So it's an application which you can download from ICT-IPR.in. Currently it is available for Android, but we hope to soon release for iOS and other platforms. Then on the ICT-IPR, basically we have a patent analysis and management system. So you can go to the portal and we do a lot of all this stuff. In terms of one can register, there are a couple of registrations already been done. These are free registrations. And whatever services we have provide is currently freely available and hope that will be available for a longer duration of time. So currently there are 9,000 registered users on the portal. So this is the some snapshot. So this is the bottom image is of Patent Search Center at DITI, while the top one is at CIDAC Pune. And then we generally try to give the reports delivered in 3-4 days and so on and so forth. And use the paid database searches for basically giving the prior art searches to you. So this is the single window interface, prior art search, invention analysis, IPR queries, patent alerts, patent landscape, technology analysis also we do, and we provide you something like news, events, successful case studies and other videos. So this is the PAMS portal, we talked about that. So this is the ICT@ipo.in. And as recently we have released this mobile app for patent analysis management system. IP Panorama, as I said to you, it's a customized version of our WIPO's IP Panorama. It's a multimedia e-learning tool for creating awareness. And it has been modified suitably in order to cater to the requirements of MSMEs as well as SMEs and startups. It is a very simple, intuitive way of basically learning. It's a maybe 10 to 15 minutes video for each of these. There are 10 modules within that, and one can get those modules depending upon this. One can actually look at those modules when you are on MOO also. So it covers basics such as patents, what is patents, fundamentals, what is patents, trademarks, how to apply, where to apply, what is the patent protection and so on and so forth, what is the design patents and so on and so forth. So this gives a lot of information. I request you, all of you, to actually download, have a look at it. If anything else is required, please come back to us, we will be able to help you out. So these are some of the IP Panorama modules, which is the importance of IP and so on and so forth, and IP audit. Maybe you can just go through that. MIT is also facilitating MIT scientists, societies, autonomous bodies and grantee institutions to file IPR applications comprising patents, copyrights and trademarks applications through its various R&D activities. So MIT do have a lot of societies basically, and a lot of research and development activities gets carried through that, and MIT through the IPR division helps them file patents. As of today, 65 granted patents with, these are the technologies which are being designed, developed, or the research which have been done at the societies. Then under the international collaboration, MIT and European Patent Office, in an endeavor to further cooperation, have signed a work plan. This work plan aims to share best practices in ICT-related patenting, especially for computer-related inventions, between Europe and India, through exchanges, training programs and workshops, and we have been recently conducting a lot of workshops nationally, internationally. So, two workshop conferences we conducted in Munich and two in India. And now on first, we are conducting a patent drafting course at Pune. And on fourth and fifth, we will be having the basically conference, Indo-Euro conference at Delhi. So maybe I would like to invite all of you over here, and you can register. I think that's from my side. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your. As they say in Malayalam, Devathinte Sondam Nadu, their own country, Kerala.